Welcome students and welcome to Avipedia. Today we are going to discuss about budgets and different types of deficits, how they are calculated. It's a very important concept from the point of view of UPSC. और इसका concept बहुत clear होना चाहिए, तब आपको समझ में आएगा कि इनका क्या impact है economy में. So let's start now. Budget is a financial statement of estimated income and estimated expenditure of the government for the coming financial year. According to Article 112 of the Constitution, a central budget is to be presented in front of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, and according to Article 202, a state budget is to be presented in front of the state legislature. All right. So basically, why a budget is presented? There are certain objectives why a budget is presented. So first, we need to have proper fiscal management in the economy. There should not be mismanagement of fund. Then we need to go for redistribution of income and wealth in the society, because we have a big gap between the rich and the poor, between the haves and the have-nots. So we want to have redistribution of income and wealth in the society to tax and transfer policy. Secondly, we need to reallocate the resources for optimum utilization of resources so that it can lead to economic growth and economic development. Then we also have to manage public enterprise through the budget, and we also need to have economic stability in our economy. Now, when I say economic stability, it means stability with employment, stability in the price level, stability in our balance of payment status, and also we need to have a desired rate of economic growth. So a budget is very important tool with the help of which there can be financial management of the country. Otherwise, it will lead to collapse of the economy. Now, let me tell you the structure of the budget. So far the structure of the budget is concerned, we have revenue budget and capital budget. It is mandatory, it is compulsory that we make a distinction between revenue budget and capital budget. Revenue budgets, they do not create an asset for the government or reduction in the liability of the government. They are basically routine income and routine expenditure of the government. And so far capital budget is concerned, that is creation of capital asset in the country and disposition of capital assets. They create a liability and also reduction in the assets of the government. All right. Now, revenue budget, it has got two aspects. One is revenue receipts, and revenue expenditure. Now, under revenue receipts, we have tax receipts and non-tax receipts. Now, tax receipts are like the government gets income from income tax, GST, sales tax, custom duties, excise duties, etc. And non-tax revenue, we have various kinds of fees, miscellaneous fees, fines, and income from public enterprise, that is non-tax revenue. This is how the government gets its revenue receipts. And revenue expenditure, they are routine expenditure on salaries, defense, all these are routine expenditure. So this is routine income of the government and routine expenditure of the government. And now capital budget, again we have capital receipts. Now, capital budget, as I have already told you, they create an asset for the government, and also they do not, they cause reduction in the liability of the government. So these relate to borrowings. And when I say capital asset, creation of capital asset, that means like asset which is not only used in the current financial year, but it is also used by the future generation. For example, let me give you an example here. Supposing there is an airport. So airport will not be used by the present generation in the current financial year. It will be used by the future generation also. And the government is the guardian of the future generation. And therefore, it becomes compulsory, it is mandatory that we make a distinction between revenue budget and capital budget. Otherwise, there will be tendency to spend all the money in the current financial year. Nothing will be left for the future generation. And that is the reason we make a distinction between revenue budget and capital budget. All right, now let me tell you, there are three types of budget. First is surplus budget. Surplus budget is when the revenue receipts are greater than, the receipts are greater than expenditure. When the receipts are greater than the expenditure, that is known as surplus budget. This kind of budget is recommended for affluent society, and basically when we have to check the inflationary pressure, we go for surplus budget. Then we have got a balanced budget. Balanced budget is when the income is equal to expenditure, revenue is equal to expenditure, that is what is called balanced budget. Basically, we are more concerned with deficit budget. Deficit budget is when the expenditure is more than the revenue, our expenditure is more than our income, that is what is known as deficit budget. This kind of budget is recommended for underdeveloped country like India, so that it leads to more economic growth and development in the economy, and it is also helpful in increasing the level of aggregate demand in the economy. So this is recommended for underdeveloped economy like India, but we have to use it with a caution that there should not be too much of deficit, that it leads to debt trap. We are trapped in debt and it becomes also inflationary in nature. So now, we are going to give you the concept of three types of deficits. Alright? So first I begin with revenue deficit. Now what is revenue deficit? Revenue deficit is when revenue expenditure is greater than revenue receipts. That means the government is not able to generate so much of income that it will be able to spend. So in that case, it leads to borrowing, it leads to disinvestment, and it can be inflationary in nature also. So we have to be very careful when we are preparing our revenue deficit. Secondly, we have our fiscal deficit. Now what is fiscal deficit? When our revenue expenditure plus capital expenditure, both of them are greater than revenue receipts plus capital receipts. Or in simple words, we can say when the budget expenditure is greater than budget receipts, we call it fiscal deficit. And fiscal deficit is very important to calculate. It also tells us about the financial health of our country. It also tells us how much borrowing is required and It also tells us about the credibility of our economy in the international market. Our credit rating will be reduced if we are too much dependent upon the borrowing. And in that case, it will hamper the economic growth of our country, because we will not be able to take loan from other countries at a lower rate of interest. We will have to go by higher rate of interest. And that will be more burdensome in the economy, and that will also affect the financial health of our country. And the third type of deficit, that is our primary deficit. Primary deficit is equal to fiscal deficit minus interest payment. It's also a very important concept. because we know how much dependence we have on the other countries for loans. And again, it will hamper our credit rating internationally, and we will have to secure loans at higher rate of interest. And again, that's going to hamper economic growth of our country. So basically, these are the concepts with our revenue deficit, fiscal deficit, and primary deficit. It's very important from Union Public Service Commission point of view. You have to understand this, then only you will be able to understand the functioning of the budget in a better way. And so that's all. I hope you have liked it, you have enjoyed it, and you have understood it. Thank you. And we see you again with a new topic.
स्टॉप कर दो।